looking at you, kid, for a long, long time.
He's looking right back at you.
I have a maid come in 2 or 3 times a week and just trash the place. You know, gives it that lived-in look. Actually, there wasn't much we didn't do last night when we finally got to be alone.
Yeah. It's all coming back to me now. Mm. This room. The couch. And the chairs and... and you. But who's this guy that's looking though? You wouldn't recognize him at all, this sad guy. Why does he have this stupid grin on his face?
Hmm? Oh, I don't remember him at all. I could have the girl. She's got this smile on her face and she's thrashing about with wild abandon, you know? But she does resemble this lawyer that I know. Is always in our office. She's divorced, kind of lonely, controlled. Pathetic, actually.
I definitely don't remember her being in this room. You know what? If I didn't know better, I'd say that I am happy. And it's because of you. So he... I want you to stay healthy. I swear.
So help me God.
So help me God. I told my father, Asa Buchanan, to stop insulting the woman I love.
Oh, yes. Well, now, is this woman present here?
Is she ever?
Could you point her out to me, please?
With the court's permission, I'll do better than that.
Are you positive that this is the woman?
Absolutely. I know by the scent of her hair, by the way that her eyes sparkle, by the way that she feels when I'm holding her against me. Her name is Nora Gannon, and I love everything about her, from her incredibly sharp mind to her incredibly bad eating habits.
And there's never a chance that you're mistaken.
Impossible. But I'd like to testify just a little bit more. Not only did she save my life and restore my faith in humanity, she did something even harder than that. She made me happy again.
Men like you were extinct. It's true. That's why I gave up looking. And I just crammed my life full of work. I filled my life with so many clouds of legal briefs. Too dense to even see how lonely I really was. And the clouds broke away. Here you are. Sunlight looking in. And I don't know how I got to be so lucky. You love me, Mr. Buchanan.
Mm-hmm.
I love you. So help me God.
You know, I saw you with me. I am just... I'm unbeatable. God, I think, you know what? I think that we could win that jitterbug contest next weekend. Hello, beautiful.
Hiya, gorgeous.
You got great legs.
So do you.
Can I make a suggestion?
Anything.
Stop that recorder, take the tape out, and burn it.
I wasn't expecting you. Yes, I was.
Guess I just can't keep away from you.
Oh, I know the feeling. You know what? This is a semi-public office, which means it's only semi-private.
Oh, yes, yes. I just, I came by to give you this.
Can I open it now?
Well, if you don't, I'm not leaving.
Fine. Oh, I can't wait. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, look. Oh, I love it.
Each charm is for something that we've done.
Yes, but not everything we've done, right? Tennis racket, golf clubs, an ice cream cone. What, no chili dog?
I tried, believe me.
You are so sweet.
I guess this just means that you've really charmed the pants off me. What you do when you can't be with the one you want to be with, and I want to be with you, you know, not for just a few minutes or a few hours a day, but like all day.
All day sounds nice.
Then why don't we just do something about it?
You know what? I think I could probably clear out a whole day next week.
Me too. And I know the perfect place where we could be alone, you know, away from everybody and everything.
I can hardly wait.
You don't have to. Modern technology. Isn't it really something? Just a flick of the wrist and all of a sudden, what's a semi-public place turns into a perfectly private place.
God, it's a great time to be alive. Oh. Mm-hmm.